trade, and there goes one point to L.R.R.P. here tonight. I'm so sorry for the tech shot. I don't know. I restarted before I started, but interesting. First point goes to L.R.R.P. We had bend over, two kills there, one kill on the East Alley there against Shotgun Preacher. Sorry. What am I saying? 2IQ found a pick onto Shotgun Preacher there, the first pick of the night, but we're gonna see whether our technology is gonna be behaving tonight. Misbehaving slightly, but nothing to worry about. I'm so sorry, folks. We should be good to go as we now are going to start round number two, indeed. We'll see if it behaves this time. Here we go. Excomm now on the defense. Stranger taking a spot on the east. Interesting strat by L.R.R.P. as they really take their time here. As well as Death Legion plus another shortly behind him. Moving into overpass. Interesting play. Minion on the north. Believe they're trying to look out for a possible, like, north aggressor, but it's not going to come out today. They will take their time, though. This spot really is going to be the one that tells us the rest of the tune here for round two. Stranger Man is the first line of defense for Excommunicado. Minion is still far behind the rest of the offense, really. We still have yet to see what's going to happen. Slow start for L.R.R.P. Oh, and that's the TK. Glad I caught that one. Rough start for the Death Legion vet. Another TK. We've got two TKs. Yikers. There goes Stranger Man, finds one. No, Shotgun can't find the refrag. It's just left up to two. Oh, Stranger finds it. Oh my gosh. It's all left up to Minion. Brutal. Absolutely brutal. Catastrophic breakdown of the MARSOC push. I'm very surprised that they weren't aware of each other. And two TKs lock in the fate of L.R.R.P. Well, actually, not yet. Minion still has free will. I don't know. I don't know if you guys want to talk about that. It's a little. Here we go, Minion. cooked nade. It goes short into that position. Would have been really good if someone was tucked in there, but Wicked and Care. Mods and admin. That flash is not going to catch Minion, and he's on their doorstep. 2 minutes, 30 seconds, plenty of time to find some loose screws in this XCOM machine. Oh my gosh, and the C4 ends it. My goodness. Big C4 by Wicked. That's what sealed the deal. XCOM take away a point here into a 1-1. I am so sorry for the tech issues. I believe we are back online. Yes, we are. Thank you to the Onward Master League channel for helping me reconnect. My goodness. We've got Shotgun Preacher with a negative one kills, two deaths. That was a tough one for L.R.R.P, but I'm sure it's not going to happen again. I'm sure we're going to see some better days for L.R.R.P on their MARSOC. Definitely shouldn't happen there on their defense. But we'll have to see. We'll just have to see. I don't know what happened. Like a wombo combo, they were just throwing tech issues. Let me go start fixing the maps. One for now. Different OBJ. This one's a classic. Far north as L.R.R.P now tackle their defense. Here we go. I believe I heard Benny actually say, no matter what, we cannot get capped on, and that's exactly right. This OBJ, it's so easy to lose it. The defenders here in the north, can, if they let go, it's all over, and the southern defenders will struggle greatly to regain it. Here goes Amali, and it's a small toss. Spread isn't too great. They can still make their way. It's slowly spreading, but... look at that C4 just off target. Could have been good. Oh, and that flash is going to catch Minion. But the Molly is a little, yeah, okay, strange. Strange, feel comfortable. That frag is going to be a TK. Luckily, it's a down as Death Legion catches zero in the far south. There goes Benny, a double kill. Mad Lad in the refrag. My gosh. Incredible play by Benny down there. Good save by Wicked, and there goes that flare. Let's see where it goes. On the stairwell. Not going to do much for now. Luckily, the smokes, they don't snuff out. Death Legion. Death Legion back here. There goes... yeah, Minion is the first line of defense. Shotgun, indeed, has the PKM. That's the classic defense layout. But Wicked isn't going to fall into that trap anytime soon. Got a lighter. A Volk lighter. Big damage done by Benny. Manages to take out three. Wicked managed to save the day, but... it could still go very wrong here for L.R.R.P. Wicked gets tagged. There goes a self-heal. He's It's going to be tough with that AUG and the PKM. Going to be very tough. Care on the underground. You might have spotted Death Legion. Actually, the M249. The shots don't connect yet.
Hide over by the tunnel ways.
There's that call up by Death Legion. Narrowly avoiding death. I'm getting nervous. I'm getting nervous for him. That's the PKM that you hear. Shotgun putting down some shots. Ooh, Care goes down. Bend manages to find him in there. It's all lift up to Wicked here. Minutes on the clock. The little go around, I feel like having to start over is quite the undertaking. Bend can, I don't know, they found Care, they could find Wicked. Wicked breathing heavy, making sure that noggin is oxygenated. Because this is going to take a lot of brain power, a lot of skill, and a little bit of luck sprinkled in. 1:30, time ticking down. The challenge here again, folks, is getting past Bendover that has the latest angle here. That managed to find Care, but also Death Legion, who is right here. Shortly could find maybe a glimpse of Wicked with their left eye at some point, but nothing is sealed. Those PKM shots, they could distract Wicked, and they've got to be careful to not make noise or any footsteps, because Bendover can start to hear. Uh-oh, Wicked may have heard something, and there goes that slow crawl. Still making some noise, though. Getting nervous. Ooh. There's Death Legion. May find it, and a quick headshot with the AK-12 seals it in. It's going to be 2-1 for L.R.R.P. GG's. Whew. Three rounds down, and I had to call in for some backup. Infused power, welcome in.
Yo, I have arrived. The man, the myth, the legend. Your favorite EU caster at 2 in the morning has showed up to assist. How's it going, chum? How's it all doing?
I'm doing good. That was an embarrassing, rough start, but at least we're back. We missed a bit of the first round, but at least...
Yeah, I did notice that things were going wrong, so I was thought, may as well see if I can help out anyway.
I needed you. I couldn't have done it without you. I'm glad you're here.
Well, you have me now.
very. I do have bans, if you'd be interested. I know you don't, aren't very familiar. I'm not very familiar with these teams, but we got bans by Excomm, Downfall in Shipyard. I'm going to write those down. And on L.R.R.P. side, we've got Arctic and Snowpeak. Anything you can make out from those picks?
There's some pretty interesting bans. You have kind of like polar opposites in some ways. You have two small maps and also two big maps being kind of taken off. Of course, Shipyard is, you know, a very, very... it's a very difficult map. You need to understand your angles and how to play them effectively. And of course, Snowpeak,
right.
You have to utilize very heavily on those lines and understanding. You know, me and you both have some Snowpeak experience from earlier today.
Yes.
We understand that Snowpeak is a very stressful map, but you know, we are now making our way into the fourth round. So, gonna be exciting. We might even see quite a hopeful North attack here coming out from LARP. Let him use it.
Oh, whoa, Zero minus Cool finds a pick on Underpass, and Bend is not there for the refrag. They're confidently peeking with the AK-12, not proning, because if Bend approaches this stairwell proning down the stairway, they could find Zero Cool before they could even see him.
This push down is like a death trap. You need to truly understand how you clear out the overpass push.
Uh-oh.
You know, in the position... If Zero Cool isn't watching, I'm pushing up. We have Over kind of making his way down those stairs. Oh, Zero's pushing out. He's going to see his leg. And out comes those shots. Gets that kill. The refrag is now going to make it down to a 4v4. It does
Benny
appear, but we're going to see. Yeah, go on.
No, I'm seeing... Whoa! C4 blown up, but nobody's here to catch it. It's L.R.R.P. and Benny that are taking their time. No! The M249 shuts that one down. Big punishment here.
I was going to say there, Shotgun Preacher and Benny were just slowly creeping their way up into the north now, but down goes... I believe that was Wicked. That's now going to put quite a strain on the defense. We're only left to the north defenders. You got Stego, Stranger Man, Karashima, and for 2IQ. This kind of leaves the rest of the center platform exposed for Minion and Over to kind of take rounds. But how are they going to adapt now? Now that they're going to be pinched between two forces.
It's going to be tough. I do want to note that it's currently a 3v4, but the XCOM defense, they are tightly wrapped around OBJ. It's going to allow... You know, offenders like, whoa, Strange Man goes down to a long grenade toss. Here comes a possible revive attempt and an M203, but it comes a little short. They're stuck here on the left. Benny might catch this rotation. No, they don't. NIQ tucks back in, but look at this defense. It's going to allow Minion and the other Marsoc pushers on, from the south to really come up on their doorstep. Maybe we're going to see a sneak cap. Strange Man doesn't seem... they're pretty much blinded here. Not much that they can see from here.
Another end of reef smoke comes out. We could see a cap, as you did say. They're now kind of pushing out. Out comes Stranger Man. Is that a nade? Or was a flash by his teammate? Very poor coordination there. And so he does flash him. He didn't get punched for it yet. He's playing for kind of a risky decision. Trying to play at the ticket machines. But might be able to spot for Minion here as he kind of pushes closer.
You might start hearing some footsteps. Oh, Bend over. Gives out footsteps, and so does Minion. Whoa, the AK-12 finds Wicked. Minion, sorry.
Oh, no.
It's a self-flash from Bend. There's Shotgun.
Oh, here comes a flash. Flash comes out. That's going to be flashing Stranger Man.
Good
down
flash.
To a 2v1, Stranger Man comes
there
in.
There goes Bend into
and
the up. No
it
way! Is he gonna cap? Stranger Man stares at him.
It's now up to Benny. He needs to clear out this north as much as he can. Stranger Man is in this probably a lot better position. As long as Stranger Man holds his ground and swings when Benny gets close, he should have this. But he doesn't know an accurate kill count. Keeps checking behind him to see if anyone's coming out from center platform.
I didn't
Benny's
hear much
creeping down those staircase.
I didn't hear much communication from XCOM's defense there. It was just too quick. Care went down. So did IQ. Uh-oh, but he's making noise.
Oh, no.
Benny knows he's down here on OBJ. Whether this position will throw Benny off, that's the real question.
This is for the type of situation you're in, this probably has to be the second best one. Ideally, you don't want to leave the objective open, as we see Benny, tablet in hand, is creeping his way up.
It's over. It's coming out.
I can see it typing in.
Plenty of time. It's all over, folks.
And the cab comes out.
Oh my gosh. And it's going to be 4-1. A nice clutch by Benny to close things out here. My goodness. Ridiculous.
I mean, it hurts. You just need to be more aware of those cap positions. A random tip to which you'll find people say, whenever you're in the tent and you look on the board, the circle around the OBJ is all the available cap positions, so you can see if you can cap through a wall or not. So if you haven't checked the places you can cap from, it's always worth checking out.
Folks, an exciting map number one. Despite some tech issues, we are back in action. Nothing's going to stop us. We'll be right back after a quick break.
Accepting, ignore, just kicking down all the doors. Guarantee you, boy, if I ask for it, it's gotta be real big. I gotta make it just for my kids and for their kids. Just kids, that's wealth years and years. Promise my brother, soon as he out of finish this bid, we finna do it bigger than anybody ever did. The odds is real big. Job, that's real big. Satan trying a little, my God, is real big. Stayed up on the grind on the cars, is real big. I gotta do it big, the only way that I can live.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are back for our next exciting map up. Quickly, Chumbe is fixing some technical issues before we get into the second map. Both teams are now both in the lobby. It is going to be quite a nice, exciting next map pick. I believe the bans were Shipyard, Arctic. I've forgotten the other two, but some pretty, smart bans coming from both teams. As, said previously, I'm not very used to some of these teams. So it's quite nice to see how different teams play and adapt. Very excited, though. We did see there was many flaws and weaknesses, and hopefully both teams can address them. The double accident of team kill has to be a nice classic. Always fun to have a good time.
Look, we saw a big cap there on Subway, but this OBJ here on map two tonight, map two is going to be quarantine. I'm not so sure. I wouldn't be so confident to say that this is the most capable OBJ. This is on ambulance. This is the hospital OBJ.
Unless your name is 24 Gray, you are not going to be able to cast this.
Right.
Not cast it, cap this. And there you go, Gray. There's your shout out. You don't have to harass me now in DMs about it. But as we get our way into the first round, I'm going to be seeing that north spawn. This is kind of a power spawn for the ARP. It does allow them to kind of spread out if they want to go to the east or go to the west in the crash building, or make their way down very fast and heavy on towards the OBJ through center burning. This is quite a dynamic spawn. It's probably one of the most easiest spawns to get. because it just gives you so much freedom, so much movability to kind of make your way around. Do see Minion is looking for any crosses. Unfortunately, wasn't able to pick out Wicked. Might have called it out though.
Around the no, you're good. Keep going, Shotgun. We already got two going that way.
Once I get to the back end of the...
What are your predictions then, Chumbait, for this round coming up?
I think
L.R.R.P... You see, you're currently looking at over in Death Legion. What do you think they're going to be trying to do?
Yeah, I just want to highlight Death Legion's drone. It's going to be really, really, really useful on Marsoc, especially on a map like Quarantine. It's going to be deadly, in my opinion. But, yeah, I mean, Hospital, there's always going to be people tucked in and in very difficult to see places. But look at Care's position outside, watching the sand dunes in the southeast. That's a a position often found. And there goes the drone. It's out of the picture. Short-lived.
So, looking at LARP so far, I think they need to learn the timings a little bit. Now, Wicked is kind of making his way into Free Story. Is he going to get spotted by Death Legion? I was going to two-story, he will get in right in a head-on with Over. Oh, both players just saw each other. Out goes a flash. Oh no, a flash and a nade. This is a very dangerous position to be in now. He has two players looking for him. He might spot Legion. Need to be careful. Over's looking for his head. He's going to spot Legion. Out goes Legion from Wicked. Does get tagged, however.
Oh, he's got to be careful on the first floor. He spots Bendover first, and that's that.
Getting ammo going.
A very, very nice double kill. Just drop his gun, going for that Marsoc round. I believe that is an AK-5C. Random tip of a bit of knowledge, if you weren't aware, the TAR can actually use MK-16 and AK-5C magazines.
Yes.
So if you're ever on Volk with a TAR and you run out of ammo, go to your nearest dead Marsoc and collecting go.
I was really surprised to actually learn that, because it was during during pub lobby. I'm like, wait, I just accidentally picked that up and loaded it, and it worked. And here comes Wicked, and I love doing this. It's an AK-5C. I'm not sure how familiar LARP are with their audio cues, but this could offer a little bit of confusion in Wicked's favor. AK-5C with no foregrip of zero gets a nice headshot onto Benny. West. Shotgun is right there to see their teammate fall. A little bit traumatic, but nothing Shotgun can't
fix. Yeah. There you go.
Nothing he can't
a little
endure.
Bit of therapy. A little bit of therapy. A little bit of a nice hot sunny day. Yeah, we'll fix anything. This just now put quite a major strain, but I want to quickly put your attention to Minion over up here in the north. We have both these players. Wicked is coming from behind. They're unaware of each other.
Oh. Like
look
yin
at
and
that
yang.
Cross. Completely accidentally cross each other. Leaving each other in the dust. This might honestly be kind of a double-edged sword now. If XCOM is expecting a east push. And of course, you have a player come through the, not east, but west person. You have a guy come through the east. Would they be looking for the east still?
I think
they had a teammate go through it.
Oh, no. No, Wicked wins that. Ooh. What a mad lad. How did he do that?
The AK-5C is a beauty.
My gosh.
And we are now down to a 1v5. Not a good look. How will the Minion adapt to this situation with only a minute and 30 seconds remaining? And he does have quite a lot to cover. However, he does have the advantage, though. He knows the location of one of the enemies. And you have to kind of expect for quite a general OBJ-focused defense. Smoke's coming out with an M23 smoke. The Stranger Man is caught out his position and is keeping eyes, but he's going to get tagged and finished off by for 2
yeah,
IQ
you were making that
on Popsicle Roof. Taking the first point for XCOM VR.
My gosh. There they go. First point on Quarantine. Yikers. I just keep having tech issues. Things are just like dying and then restarting. Anyways, L.R.R.P has won Subway, the map number one, 4-1, and they just got, Excomm just got a point. Did I do the wrong team? I did.
Still haven't got in the original scores for the first map. How dare
you? I know, I didn't even realize they were broken. Yes, what a contrast to earlier today. My God.
You went from the most beautiful organized cast. Honestly, I had some comments about it in my DM saying how beautifully that ran, how smooth it was, how it was so perfect, how everything was clean. And it's now like, what now? Don't even have the first map in. Don't even know what the first map was. This is not looking good, chum, mate, man. You're sick.
I'm getting kind of
nervous.
I'm working on it. But, okay, here we go. Map one.
Hey, it happens.
Subway. Map two. Here, let's roll for you. Good attempt by Minion. I really like that M203 placement, but that 2IQ second floor of hospital really was just, you know, the perfect counter.
For a man of only 2IQ, he knows a good position to hold.
Oh yeah.
I give him that.
Oh yeah.
Most definitely gonna look forward to this round. This has to be one of the hardest spawns, in my opinion, to get for this objective now. Moving up. We're gonna be taking the northeast quarantine spawn on the second round. We are seeing, is this gonna be a five man east rush? If so, I'm looking forward to it. Haven't seen anybody go to money truck. So it looks like they're going very east heavy.
It really does seem like that.
I have not seen a five-man Easter push in my entire life. Oh, Wicked is risking it big time here to cross the street so widely. Realistically speaking, but Minion might spot him. Oh, Wicked gets tagged by Minion. He might get finished off here on the second cross. Oh!
Had one getting all jumpy.
He's risking everything. But he now is able to call out to his team, and there's going to be a guy on that street facing them.
Oh, I'm really looking forward to IQ.
Oh, Care's about to swing it. Care's swinging it. I think. Oh,
Minion's out of sight. Care's free to swing. But this aggression, it actually might come to bite XCOM. Who's exposed here? Stranger might get caught by Minion in case they decide to push out. Maybe Care eventually, but.
If anybody dares, we need to go through underground parking garage. I'm about to shoot you a 3 on the.
I'll go for underground.
Minion is gonna hear Stranger push into the underground and may operate. Yeah, they will hear them underground. M203 launch from the East Apartments building. Stranger's right below Minion. Stranger wants to go for Cap. I hear him whispering the code under his breath, but.
That might put me up pretty close. I'm in underground.
It's not a good look when you're whispering stuff to yourself.
Well, Onward players, they can understand if it's the code.
Oh, Wicked's about to get a kill onto Dover. Down goes Dover from Wicked.
There goes Benny, finishing Stranger off. But Wicked, they completely missed Stranger. That shot onto Benny doesn't lock in. And Minion behind the tank can't get this pick on Courtyard. Here's some smoke tosses. He may not have gotten the immediate frag, and that flash is a little high. Here comes Minion. Kill inbound. L.R.R.P find another. It's three left on XCOM, but Minion is still stuck. They're on OBJ. They could cap this.
Oh,
here comes
a frag. About to take a Stranger.
No, Stranger invades it perfectly. Death Legion is going to have to push into the smoke in order to cap it. Here's some distract three shots, and Death actually flicks onto him. What in God's name was that? Shocked with a kill of his own. Zero cool flicks on OBJ, and there's Minion.
Wow.
the force of nature at the very end when he was needed most. Lerp, take a point.
There was so much happening in that round. I was so confused throughout most of it.
I apologize. It's Lerp who took the point, not Excomm. I pressed the wrong button. And since
we'll get there one day, John. We'll get there one day.
God,
I'll have to send you back to caster training.
I really might need it.
Casting 101, how to use the caster package. A important thing, Chumbe, is to make sure you put the scores on the right teams. It normally helps quite a lot.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I am your sunshine in your pitiful bit of rain and dark clouds. Keeping it through. Here's a question to you, though.
Sure.
Have you tried digital NVGs?
On
like downhill.
On downhill.
Yeah.
You know, I remembered when it used to be really helpful to see the dark spots, but since they fixed the lighting, I guess not on quarantine or downfall recently, but I think quarantine has gotten better.
I get that.
I used NVGs for season 15, if that's what you're asking.
Yeah, but... I get what you mean. It's with the new NVG changes.
Right.
You see, there's something which I got my attention because of a K4 player. I believe it was EG. Mm. EG was using, what's it called? Digital lenses on downfall, and you're looking at it. It just makes all the rooms really bright. It increases the contrast. So spotting Volks through windows from far away is just super easy. And I've been using it ever since.
That might come in handy. I don't know that.
Well, it's really interesting, man.
Folks, we're going to go straight into
round number three.
Round number three.
I swear I just saw your overlay have zero scores on it.
I know. It's because Stream Helpers keeps dying on me. It keeps crashing. I don't know why, but I'm gonna persevere.
No. He's going to keep fighting no matter what happens.
Exactly. Here we go. Round number three. Jeez, a big pick onto Zero. Headshot. Headshot on tank courtyard.
That is a pretty important kill. But down goes Wicked. Free fire's coming out. Down goes a drone. Two Excomm players down already. That is definitely gonna hurt.
Care trying to shut down that drone. Might have happened already. Yeah, drone seems to be out. Shocking got a good pick, but they got to keep that ball rolling.
Went over towards hospital somewhere.
We do see about now Over has taken control of the North AC building. Will be kind of important position. You do see that 2IQ does hear him though. Has been calling it out. Dover might hear it.
Shotgun, you left. Or he's right below me on AC.
He's calling out to his team. Shotgun is now looking at the yellow barrels. You might see a nade come out from both sides,
idea.
It looks like.
Good thinking, but not quite.
Oh no! The third team kill, and he shot and throws his tablet in shame.
We have somebody on the fucking hospital roof. Took the guy out on objective.
Fortunately, Minion is able to take out Stranger Man on the OBJ. Redeems some form of sadness coming from a team kill. The shotgun reaches, run into objective though. He doesn't even have a tablet. A maniac runs in. He's going to be seeing Care.
Care didn't even notice.
Runs out with the one hand.
That was wild.
MK16 one hand. That's a first.
Whoa! That was cool.
I got the one that shot Benny.
Oh, Death Legion might be able to catch Care. Care might have seen this cross. They're trying to hunt. They're not there. Ooh, so close. Kerr actually tucks back into cover at the last minute. Death Legion may see a barrel. There goes a wide peek, and oh my gosh, the timing. Kerr's still there. Not anymore. Death Legion, they take the point, and that's a win for LRRP. Folks, we will be right back after a quick ad break. Here are the KDs. We're going to fix them, resolve some issues. We'll be right back.
Accepting, ignore, just kicking down all the doors. Guarantee you, boy, if I ask for it, it's gotta be real big. I gotta make it just for my kids and for their kids. It's kids, that's wealth, years and years. Promise my brother, soon as he out of finish this bid, we finna do it bigger than anybody ever did. The odds is real big, job that's real big. Satan trying a little, my God is real big. Stayed up on the grind on the cars is real big. I gotta do it big, the only way that I can live.
Welcome back, folks. And just like that, magically, we have everything back where it's supposed to be. L.R.R.P.
Return of the solid caster. Back for vengeance.
2-1 here on quarantine. We're just about ready to start round number four. What is going on with me? Oh my gosh.
Jumbait, man. Jumbait. Is this
I'm
what
losing
happens
it.
When you cast NA matches?
And
I think
EU.
You should stay to EU.
Oh gosh, here we go. Same OBJ, directly in the west. Same with L.R.R.P. on the east, defending the OBJ. IQ does spot shotgun, and the AUG doesn't catch him. M203 by zero. A smoke placed onto minion. That visibility is literally zero. Why is that M203 so high? Look at these smokes. Look at Benny.
This is the Blitzkrieg approach.
Look at Benny.
Do this.
Shotgun goes down by Kerr with the M249. There's one. Come on, give me a second, Benny. There's Wicked with the quick refrag. Ben.
Oh, no. Wicked didn't have his gun properly suited, so he gets taken up by Over. Still down to a 3v3. Is that a... The flash just barely misses.
Yeah. Here comes
be
a better
really stressed
smoke.
Out right now.
A trade between Stranger and Death Legion. Oh, there goes Kerr. Oh, and a trade. How do they do that? It's a double trade. There goes the confirm. Minion is the left. Last one up with 2K. 2IQ. L.R.R.P. find a third point. How have they managed that? That was chaotic.
That is really the exact chaotic. Word I was thinking to say. That was pure chaos. They did the Blitzkrieg attack, absolutely nail it with smokes and utility, rush onto the objective. Unfortunately, there was just some untimely deaths due to not clearing the corners out properly.
My gosh.
That could have been a possible cap then for Excomm if they nailed that a little bit faster and a little bit more precise, clearing out the underneath section and clearing the left side corner. You don't often see, in fairness, someone run out into the left corner of the, you know, tank courtyard, so... Interesting to see it come out tonight, so definitely have to keep your eyes open for unusual, you know, off-meta positions, which definitely catch off some of the more experienced players.
I was surprised that IQ was already there. I didn't see them get there. They came to a complete surprise to me that they were able to clean up Wicked. I didn't notice them. I don't know how I didn't notice them. I got lasered. I got tunnel vision on Benny, where he only got one pick before getting the refrag. But it was a good round. It seems that L.R.R.P. is on track to get in this matchup. 3-1. All they need is just one more Marsoc round.
one more Marsup round and hopefully not one more team kill. Keep it in, fellas. Keep it in.
So how many TKs is that in this matchup between both teams? Well, I think it's four, right?
I've joined in and there was a double team kill on Subway. And then there was one from Shotgun Preacher.
Just now, so maybe three.
Second last round.
Okay.
So, three from LARP, I believe. Well, not I believe. Maybe four? I'm not exactly sure. There's been so many. Who's there to count them?
Here we go. Next OBJ is going to be inside Terminal. This one's in an interesting spot. We may see a cap attempt as long as LARP are disciplined in using good smoke. Here we go, folks.
They do have the very fast quick spawn here in the southeast at the hospital. If they execute this properly, they could well and truly take some major ground. We do see Karashima make a way into the northwest, we call it northwest factory. Quite a... nice kill there. Onto two-story, that makes a gap in the defense. Wicked is in the vault courtyard, looking towards Death Legion.
Wicked finds a kill.
Death Legion.
Minion, all he needs to do is just look, and he gets the pick. There he goes. Flash out. And there goes Zero Cool on the fuselage. This is not looking good for Excomm. Shotgun somehow manages to win that engagement with Stranger. The OBJ is completely open. It's all left up
and
to Care.
Cap.
Yeah,
cap
it's completely
open.
Care's
the way to make this.
Benny cannot hesitate. They gotta keep going.
Tablet's coming out. We can see them coming through the corridor.
It's all over,
come
folks.
On, Care. Get those legs
it's
moving
over.
To the cap.
Beautiful.
Beautiful cap from Benny. 5-1.
Oh my gosh.
Beautiful. That was a fast cap.
I cannot believe it. 5-1 here, folks, on Quarantine by LARP. They have done such
They've
an amazing
slammed
job.
Slammed it through the park.
Jeez.
No better way to put it.
Big win here on Quarantine. I'm really thoroughly impressed. Incredible.
Oh my god. This map again.
We're gonna go to a quick break. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Round one of Suburbia for map three. L.R.R.P. Oh my gosh, the lag. L.R.R.P. has officially won. Minus here comes 2IQ. Another P90 player finds a pick on mid.
We are going to be seeing Benny, which is now... Oh, is that a beautiful... Oh, it's a flash. A nice kill there under zero. Cool. You got me so hopeful. Would have had Stranger and Wicked with a nade. It's got the entire team focused on him now. Four versus four. Kev's looking through that smoke. Wicked is now swinging. Bunny peeks up. Is... Oh!
What? Wicked.
Is it...
Did Wicked not him. See? Oh my god! Benny finds a double and a refrag by Kale! What?
Oh my god. Why didn't you pre-fire at Wicked?
And look at Shotgun behind him on lane three.
That's where his gun was
picking
out as well.
Oh! Care heard 2IQ say there's one on the back, and they just got shot three times before going down.
Well, I guess that is the definition. There is definitely a guy in the back. Down to a 1v3, 2IQ with the P90. Shotgun Preacher is creeping his way up with an AK-12.
Making noise. Not staying quiet here.
Taken out.
Shotgun did clip him though.
That means it's not.
Oh, death.
Death.
What a pick! Ooh. Another headshot with the P90. Beautiful kill. It's all left up to Bend.
Dover's gonna get taken out here. Ooh. If he peeks up, he will see. Both these players are just crawling. 2IQ's gonna see him. He doesn't see him in time and he gets picked off by Dover. Making it the first point going to LARP.
Good try there.
So close there. Nice triple kill coming out. Excellent from 2IQ.
I kinda like Suburbia. I'm liking Suburbia. I'm seeing some good things here.
Suburbia.
Love-hate relationship, I guess.
Oh, I have a hatred for the Suburbia. Okay. I there's nothing about the map. I actually really like the map. It's just the performance issues I have on the map. It just makes me want to cry.
On PC?
There's, I think, I don't know if they fixed it yet, because I haven't actually played Suburbia since, since the Dark Ages, but there was an issue with 4090 series.
Okay.
With, like, 40 cards and 30 cards, where
you
would have,
that.
Like, 20 FPS.
I think I remember that. Okay.
Yeah, so. Plus to me, it's a testimony to have such a expensive GPU to not even been able to run one map.
cool flex, bro. Thanks
cool
for sharing.
Flex. Don't worry. I'll be casting 4K tomorrow just to even double flex it.
Oh my gosh. See, nothing's going wrong. Where's L.R.R.P.'s name tag? I don't see their name tag.
Tonight we have Excomm versus Kronos.
No, I'm just...
Now we're back to LARP.
Yeah, something ridiculous.
We need to fix your package out. Oh, my.
It's just that name. I don't know what happened. Anyways, here we go. Round number two, folks. Excomm now. Switch over to their defense side. Same OBJ in the far west. Here we go. Same spawn at Volkhaus for the Marsoc. A quick smoke on OBJ. Interesting, as Death Legion posts up on the second floor. Stranger is going to be out of sight as Wicked and 2IQ shoot some tar shots through the hedges. Shotgun already north of playground. Very aggressive play. I wonder if Wicked heard anything. Making a lot of noise.
He's using the tiny SMG, isn't he?
Yeah, the UMP.
That's not the UMP.
No, what is it called? I know it's Ursek or something.
It's got the really small one with a suppressor and a foregrip. He's a scary man. Oh, Minion might have just got tagged there. play some free fire.
Whoa. There goes Care defending the far east, lane 4, under control. Oh, here comes Benny, though. 2IQ doesn't see any of this. They are so close to Stranger. Stranger must be hearing these footsteps and tablet noises. There goes Wicked Debt. There's the Versec. It's a V, not a U. Wicked takes out Death Legion. Callout's coming out. Ooh, there's Stranger picking up one. Ben, unfazed, hearing the AK-12 shots ringing in his ears behind him. No, he's laser focused on Wicked. Somehow, for some reason. Oh, they pick up 2IQ, that's why, but they still got to be careful of Stranger. The AK-12 shots, they're still unfazed, and Wicked pinching from mid lane. What was that? It's all up to Dominion.
He needs a new pair of headphones.
He's just staring at him. What the heck was that?
I think our good old friend needs to invest in a nice pair of HyperX Pro headphones. One of our sponsors in the VRML. Check them out.
If you are interested
on their website.
If you are interested in a great audio solution, check out the Cloud 3s, wired or wireless. I'm rocking the wired ones. I've been rocking them. This is the microphone from the wired, and this is a $100 something headset. So do check it out, and please use VRML. Wait, what's the code again? VRML.
That is a good question. Now let me just quickly check.
I think it's HXVRML24, but I might be wrong.
I mean, if you know that by heart, I believe you better than I do.
No. I'm gonna make sure.
Check it myself now.
Who gets to find it first?
It's HXVRML23.
No, it's 24. It's 24. We've got the updated.
Oh, okay.
That document's updated,
So you get 15% off of HyperX products. Ooh. Very nice. Anyway, instead of selling our lives away, let's check back. We're going to see Minion, who might spot Care down goes Kirishima.
Oh my gosh. Looking away at the perfect wrong time. 2 minutes 30 seconds. Minion slowly chipping away at this defense. They got to keep going, bouncing from exit to exit. Now in the south, they seem to be circling back to lane 1.
The Minion kind of caught in this 1v2. It's going to be really challenging for him. He needs to kind of make that ground. He needs to establish his attack approach. Because you have all this time, you don't exactly have any identifications of where the last enemies are remaining. Of course, you can assume that there's going to be one person near the objective, maybe one near the white car, but he's going to be playing this safely. He's going to be slowly crawling up through the lane 1, just trying to avoid making any audio as much as possible to allow him to have a higher chance of getting an early pick and a sneak attack onto the Stranger Man 1-2-3. Just currently hiding in between the bed and the cargo hull of the truck, which is over on its side.
He is looking down the sights of that. He's like sniffing the gun barrel right now. He's got that. He has a relationship with his Virtus. Stuck to his face. He is locked in for this clutch, 1v2 clutch.
You're the only person I know who calls it the Virtus instead of the MCX.
Never mind that. Look at this pick.
Oh.
I don't know if you can see that barrel. I don't think he noticed the barrel. The barrel from Stranger.
Oh, no.
He doesn't see that barrel. He didn't see it. Oh my gosh, is he going to run straight into... Is he going to back up straight into Stranger? I think that's what might happen. Oh no.
Oh,
it's all over.
Punished.
Fucking turned his back to me.
Ay, ay, ay.
Didn't spot the gun barrel. That must have been... I don't know what he plays on. If it's a Quest 2, it must have been like as a part of the truck.
That's cool.
I can only assume if he did see it. That is unfortunate.
Very unfortunate. You took the words right out of my mouth.
To be fair, I've never seen anyone ever play there before, so even I would get caught off guard if I was
really,
you know, looking for it. I have not seen anyone play there.
I think that's an NA spot, because I always see somebody playing there. I swear.
I don't know, you NA people, you do some weird stuff, I'll be honest with you. Hey, I've played this game now for, what, 3 seasons? I've seen some interesting stuff in my times, but I've never seen anyone play that truck.
Nothing beats the genius of us Western players.
You Western players, you mad lads, living on a dream.
Hey, talk to me about this next OBJ. It's still in the north, right next to that semi-truck OBJ, but this time it's on white car next to the Hescos. Let's process this out, because I don't know what to make of it. I mean, I think there's a quick peek, right, on this OBJ from the second floor.
For this objective, you can get a pretty nice pre-fire down lane one if they go for a lane one push. But this one, I kind of imagine they're going to be going for quite a even split, maybe like 2, maybe 3-2 split, taking control of center 3 and 4, with an LMG maybe going to what I call the Great Wall of China, which is actually the the northeast container concrete stacked.
Gotcha. Well, you guys, now we know what to look out for, folks. Here we go, round number 3, going straight in.
We do gonna have Diver get the way up into the white car position. Benny going for is he going for the same position as well?
No.
No, he goes for the normal position next to the hedge. Arguably seeing quite a heavy north east side approach attack here. Going for that lane full push. I'm gonna be seeing the smoke cross, I hope. Smokes are coming out. I'm gonna be seeing a 4-man cross. There's a gap in the center. This happened earlier, Chumbait. We saw this earlier.
Yeah, we did.
Smokes have been corrected.
IQ might find death here on lane 3. He locks in and a headshot with the P90 again. P90 people are on fire tonight. There goes Shotgun down with the AUG by Wicked. As 2IQ finds another headshot with the P90. The P90 god reduces Lerp down to just 2 players.
This is not good so far. Down to a 5-2. We have them rushing the objective, going in so hard and fast. Avenger swing the corner, will be getting taken out by the minion.
Uh-oh, here comes 2IQ coming in from the back. Benny, are you ready for this? 2IQ's got to be careful, he's going to give out audio cues to minion. Even to Benny, there goes the P90, no, Wicked shuts that down, and 2IQ goes in for the spin. Finding minion behind the fence.
That had to be probably the most well-executed lane 4 push I've ever seen in my entire life.
It was wide open.
I have to give huge props to XCOM there. I don't think I've ever seen such a beautiful lane 4 push.
It was wide open for him. Jeez. And that minion managed to find one, but that was such a strong kill onto Benny. Just immediate kill, and yeah, so powerful.
I think for this next round, they have to be kind of cautious about it. I think one of the biggest faults of why they fell so heavily was for LARP's sake, because they didn't have a dedicated lane 4 protector. Lane 4 didn't really expose himself out. I say, if you want to try to make your way to the red car, try to go to the wrapped car, you have a quite a nice angle to kind of watch that lane 4 to look underneath the school bus. All those smokes, they cause a major distraction, so you should have your team pre-firing as much as they can into those smokes if you see them or hear them crossing, just for the sake of maybe getting it down to 2.
Did you call them LARP? Because they're
LARP.
They're not LARPers.
I don't know. How do you pronounce this team name?
I've always heard it LARP, like a U in it.
But that's a U though. It's a LARP. It's an R.
LARP.
LARP.
I guess because you're British, you say your R's differently.
Whoa,
calm down.
How dare you, Jumbait? How dare you? British. Yikes. My love for you has disappeared after that, Jumbait.
Oh, gosh. Don't even.
Anyway, into round 4. We'll see. See if you can redeem yourself in my heart.
That's going to be my objective right now. But nobody's posted up on the second floor of Volk House, and so they weren't able to control the cross. Whoa, a nice tray with the Versec and Death with an AK-5C. But that was all the way over there in lane 4, where no more defenders reside there now. 2IQ making some moves, actually. Rotating to lane 2.
Stranger Man's in a very hot position here, playing at this barricade, super close to so many enemies. Does need to be worried about over, though, in the window. Especially if he's making out all these callouts to his team. Benny's trying to blind fire over the hedge. That was a nade. Oh, too short, unfortunately. That would have been beautiful.
Whoa.
But down goes Stranger Man from the minion. Pushing out on the further left side on that lane 1 push.
There goes Urokul finding shotgun lane 3. Where's 2IQ when you need him to control lane 2 and 1? Here comes Ben coming in, and 2IQ will definitely hear these footsteps. Those AUG shots don't connect. There's the pre-fire, and he finds the kill. Oh my gosh, there goes Care. Minion needs to get that refrag. They do, and they are on OBJ. A nice flash, it will catch them, and 2IQ doesn't fall for that feigned dead body. They close it out. 3 points now in Suburbia. Excomm coming from the ashes.
I just heard a typical Onward moment.
What happened?
The guy was just saying, you showered Echo 3 when I was only Echo 1.
Every time.
I love when that happens.
Best thing about Onward is that you get to yell at your teammates when they give you bad kill counts.
I just yell at my teammates anyway.
There you go.
It's part of the trade, to be honest. Everyone knows deep down that I would never shout at them with awful intentions. Well, that's what they think.
Right, right.
Anyway. Do I mention this or do I not? I think I don't mention this. It's way too out of context to mention it. Did you know that the power infrastructure in Suburbia makes absolutely no sense? All the power lines make absolutely no sense. They don't attach.
You wanna make a complaint to DPI?
I think I actually will. Yeah, I will go through this entire map, talk about how it makes absolutely no sense based on logical things. There's no transformers. Why does all these houses have separate power cables? It's just one wire going into the roof. I am going to complain to DPI. I'm going to send a very upset email to their email address regarding all the changes I want to see. I want to see more accurate power lines which lead to a power station with a circuit box.
We need Zuckerberg to come in and fix this himself in Unity.
Glue wants a transformer in Suburbia. That's what I want. That's all I want in my life. Jeez. I want to see a central power supply for this town.
That's interesting. Maybe that's why burning is burning.
It's an electrical fire because it has like a...
It's short-circuiting.
It causes some fire. It's a 10,000 watt power line going straight into its house. The poor toaster's fine for its life in there.
The toast, the bread just caught on fire. The toaster was just too powerful.
The bread could not handle the heat.
It could not. I don't think anyone could. Round number 5 underway. Here's
anyway,
the scores on the board.
Not all wonder is lost, but we sure are.
L.R.R.P. now on defense. Excomm taking Marsoc. Just a shout out. 2IQ, 8-2 KD with the minion with a 5-4 there on L.R.R.P. Good stuff by Excomm. Again, leading 3-1. Good smoke onto minion. They are really pushing burning building. And rightfully so. Minion's going to be peeking. Oh, Care might find this. Yes, they do. And there goes a confirm by Wicked, actually. Good teamwork there. They have control of lane 4, and that's not good. These smokes are not the best placed. And this second floor position, no Care, absolutely yoinks them out of the lobby. Shotgun finds the double, but it's only a down onto Stranger. Soon a call out. There's the refrag, and that's it. Care finishes it off with 2IQ as well with Death Legion. 4 points here on Suburbia, folks. That's it.
feels really anticlimactic to watch NA people. I'm so used to it always coming down to the last moments with these teams.
No.
But a very well executed attack though from Excomm. They punished. They punished very heavily, and they've taken this map with full glory, taking advantage of the M3 smokes and the mass amounts of utility to put pressure, rushing in hard, getting those kills to make their way to the objective. They played that how they had to, and it went very well for them.
I'm surprised that P90 got so many headshots. I think it's because with the the P90 has such high vertical recoil that the first two or three rounds hit the chest, don't do any damage, but that's the headshot. That's the bullet that finds the kill. I swear that's the reason why we kept seeing two. There's another headshot with the P90 right there for the 2IQ. But it's just the theory and onward theory, but that's going to be it for us. A really interesting suburbia here. XCOM, they officially lose the matchup, but they win strong. 4-1 here on suburbia. L.R.R.P, take it home. This is just week one. We've got 12 more weeks left of high octane, fast onward action. So be sure to check us out. We have the VRML Con has invited Onward because Meta has failed to sponsor and fly out the finalists. So it's really up to us if we want to see the end of Onward in the best on stage. We want to see the finals on stage. So please, if you are in support of the league, if you're in support of the players, please be sure to look at that double kill by Benny. Be sure to donate at the link in the description just right down below. Please support us in our attempt to bring back Onward to the live esports stage. Thank you so much for watching. My name was Chumbate, my co-caster Infused. We'll catch you next time.